Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Sunita Kharchane from SP Union School and Junior College. Today we'll be learning Standard 10th Political Science Chapter 1 Working of the Constitution Part 2. In the second part of this chapter, we are going to learn about the social justice and equality, the policy of reservation of seats, the Scheduled Caste and Tribes Prevention of Atrocity Act, the provisions for minorities and the laws relating to women and the provisions for representation. So let's begin with social justice and equality. Social justice and equality are the important objective of our constitution. The constitution has given the guidelines, that is the rules, to establish, that means to create a new society based on these two values, and the two values are social justice and equality. We are following the path, that is the way, which is laid down by our constitution to achieve these goals. To establish social justice is to remove those social conditions which are responsible for injustice and insist on the equality of dignity, that is the respectful and honorable treatment for all individuals. The principles of justice and equality aims at ending discrimination, that is ending all the differences in social status such as superior or inferior on the basis of caste, religion, language and gender, place of birth, race, property and giving equality of opportunity for development of every individual. To establish justice and equality, efforts are to be made at all levels of society. That means the people should come united. People should come united, the efforts should be taken by all the different levels of a society. But the government's efforts and policies on this front are more important. So the major role is should be done by the government. Government has to take more efforts into it because the policies will be done by the government and which are more important. For democracy to be inclusive, inclusive means including various aspects, one must try to bring all sections of society into the mainstream. Democracy is in fact a process of accommodating. Accommodating means including different sections of people of society. Democracy helps in reducing social conflicts. Conflict means a serious disagreement amongst the people of the society. Let us see about the policy of reservations of seats. Policy of reservation of seats is meant for those sections of society who have been deprived of opportunities for education and employment for a long period of time. So here deprived means some people are there who are lacking a specified benefit and that are treated to be very important, but these people are kept away from getting all such a benefit. Such a people are said to be deprived of opportunities of education and employment for a longer period of time. Accordingly, in educational institution and in government services, some seats are kept reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. There is also a provisions of reservations of seat for all other backward classes. The Scheduled Caste and Tribes Prevention of Atrocity Act. This is an important act of establishing social justice and equality. This act prevents any injustice against the people belonging to Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe and any act of atrocity. Atrocity Act means any type of cruel act, typically involving a physical violence and an injury, committed against them, liable, that is responsible by law for the punishment. So if any person is found to be doing any type of atrocity against any person belonging to the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe, then that person is liable, that is that person is responsible by the law for the punishment. So such a type of atrocity act is made for the protection of the Scheduled Caste and the Scheduled Tribe people. Provisions for minorities. The Indian Constitution has made several provisions for the protection of minorities. Now, minorities are those people whose population is less than the 50% to the whole population of a nation. Those are said to be the minorities. The government has adopted several policies for minorities to provide them the opportunities for education and employment. The Indian Constitution prohibits that means does not allow discrimination, that is any differences on the basis of caste, religion, race, language and region. This is a comprehensive provision for the minorities. Comprehensive means it includes nearly all the aspects, and so it is called to be as a comprehensive provision for minorities, which fundamentally protects the rights to equality, freedom, right against exploitation and cultural and educational rights. So below you can see the population in descending order of minorities in India. So the Muslim, Christians, Sikh, Buddhist, Jain and Parsis. So these are the minorities of our nation. Laws relating to women and provisions for representation. In the post-independence period, that means after the independence of our nation, efforts were made for empowering women. Empowering means making the women more stronger and confident, especially in controlling their life and claiming their rights. It's called as a empowering. Taking into consideration the problems of women, several policies have been adopted at national and international level to remove illiteracy among women and to make available opportunities for their development. So, to make the women literate, various missions and various provisions have been made by the governments. So, once the woman is literate, she is able to read and write, she can educate well, and she can get lot and lot of opportunity for the development. The right to have an equal share in the property of her father and husband, Dowry Prohibition Act. Dowry, it means an amount or a property or a money brought by a bride to her husband on her marriage, that is called to be as a dowry. So Dowry Prohibition Act has been formed, that is prohibiting the dowry system. Act Against Sexual Harassment, Domestic Violence Prohibition Act are some important provisions which creates a favorable environment for protection of freedom of women and securing their development. In our country, from the very beginning, women have inadequate, means less representation in the political institution. Political institution means the organization, those creates, enforces and apply the law, like the political system or the elections or political parties and legislatures. These are the political institutions. Many countries in the world have made efforts to increase the representation of women. From this perspective, that means from this point of view, changes are taking place in India as well. The 73rd and 74th amendment means the change in the constitution. It reserved 33% of seat for women in local self-governing institution. That is, according to the changes which were made, according to that, 33% of seats were kept reserved for the women in local self-governing institutions like the municipalities, municipal corporations or Gram Panchayat. This percentage has been raised to 50% in several states including Maharashtra. So previously it was 33% reservations were kept, but now there is increase in the percentage. Now from 33% it has come to 50% in many states in India including Maharashtra. A National Commission for Women has been established. Similar commission also exists at the state level. So National Commission of Women, that is NCW. This is a governmental organization working at a national level and which is concerned with all the matters which are affecting the women. So at a national level and also at a state level, we have such a commissions. The Act for Protection of Women Against Domestic Violence is an important step in the direction of democracy. This act underline means emphasized the need to protect the dignity and self-esteem of women. This act rejected traditional form of domination and authoritarianism and expanded the scope of Indian democracy to make it inclusive in true sense. So this is the end of the second part of the chapter, Working of the Constitution. In the third part, that is the last part of the chapter of Working of the Constitution, we are going to learn about the role of judiciary, the basic framework of constitution, and the significant judicial decision.